Hi, my name is Andy Ravenna, and I'm a technical trainer. I imagine you're here because you want to understand a bit about the SORT procedure and how it works with the descending option. Well, that's exactly what I'm going to tell you about. I probably don't need to talk to you about why you want to sort your data. You're already here. You already have a good reason to have your data in a certain order. However, later I will talk to you about why you might not need to sort your data. So stay tuned for that. But let's start here. I've created a very simple data set based off of my hobby of photography. I created some metadata about photographs I've taken. This data is loosely based on actual photographs that I took. Let's take a look at the data. So you can see here, I'm actually reading in a total of 4 columns here. The first column is aperture. Now, aperture controls the amount of light that reaches the image sensor. Smaller numbers mean that more light comes into the camera and less is in focus. We sometimes refer to that as shallow depth of field. So what that means is you've probably seen those photographs where the people look really nice up front and you get this really pretty blurred background. ISO is the next variable or column that I want to read in, and ISO actually measures the sensitivity of the image sensor. Higher numbers allow you to capture darker scenes. So that means higher ISOs are probably photos that I took at dusk or at night. Then we also have the focal length of the lens, and that's an indicator of the distance of the subject of the photograph. Smaller or shorter focal lengths have a wider angle of view, and we actually tend to use those for landscape photos, for example. And then finally, I'm reading in the country that I took the photo in. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to read in all of this data, and then I'm going to do a print on it, just so that we can see what it looks like in the default order. In other words, the order that we read it in. So as you can see, this is the order of the data that it currently is. It read it in row by row, and so the first row of data over here is going to be the first row of data in my new data set. Now let's go ahead and start talking about sorting. So the first thing that I'd like to do is use the sort procedure on this data set called photos, and we're going to create a brand new sorted data set called sorted. We're going to first sort by aperture. So let's see what happens when we run the sort procedure and we sort just by aperture. We take a look at the sorted data over here, and you'll notice that it's now sorted by numerical order in the aperture column. One of the other things that you'll notice is that I have a missing value. Now that missing value occurs first when we sort because it's considered the smallest possible value. So missing values are going to show up first here. And then we can see the increasing aperture. Now let's not stop there. Let's suppose that I want to sort by not only aperture, but I also want to sort by country. So you'll see that first I'm sorting by country. We'll call that my primary sort variable. And then we're going to sort by aperture. So within each of the countries, we're now going to sort by aperture, which is my secondary sort variable. The other thing that I want you to notice as I'm running this is you can see that by default, that SAS is sorting these columns in ascending order. So now that I've sorted first by country and then by aperture, you'll notice here are my countries. And oh, look at that, we have another missing value. You'll notice that that one came first for the country. And then we have photos that were first taken in Budapest, then in New Zealand, and then the USA. Now within all of the photos that I took in Budapest, you can now see that the aperture is going to be in ascending order. So within each country, we're going to see ascending apertures. And then when we get to the next country, New Zealand, we would call that our next by group because we've sorted by country. you can see that New Zealand is going to start with that missing value. So I guess that photo that I took in New Zealand, I didn't capture the aperture. And then we've got the ascending values of aperture. And then for my USA photos, once again, we can see the increasing aperture. So in this example, country was my primary sort variable, aperture was my secondary sort variable, and they're both sorted in ascending order. Let's suppose now what I'd like to do is I'd like to have some of the data sorted in descending order. So what I'm going to do is in front of country, I'm going to add the descending keyword, and you can see that SAS Studio recognizes that option, first of all, by popping it up so that I could click on help if I wanted it, and then also by giving it this nice color-friendly blue. So we know that SAS and SAS Studio recognizes that option. So now country is going to be my primary sort variable. It is going to be in descending order. But since we did not use the descending keyword in front of aperture, aperture is still going to be in ascending order. So let's run this. And now what we would expect to see is that my countries are flipped around. We're going to start with the USA country because now country is in descending order. And then within each of my USAs, we'll notice the increasing apertures. Now let's say that I wanted the data sorted both country and aperture in descending order. What are we going to do? Well, we're going to come in here and I'm going to add that descending keyword a second time. So you'll notice that we have to put the descending keyword in front of every variable that we want in the descending order. Otherwise, it's going to be ascending by default. So now we've got the country column, USA is coming first, and then we'll notice the apertures are now in descending order because that's what I asked for. One of the questions I often get from my students is, hey, Andy, is there an ascending order? In other words, can I type ascending in order to ask SAS to do it in that order? And the answer to that question is no. So you'll actually get a syntax error if you try typing in ascending. So we won't do that. All right, I want to show you one more thing, and then I want to talk to you about how we can compare this to SQL or structured query language. I'm going to come in, and I'm actually going to add in a third variable, the ISO. So now I've got a primary, secondary, and tertiary sorted variables, and I'm going to ask for ISO in the default order, which is ascending order. So let's try that. We add that third column. Hopefully that's not going to make your brain hurt, and you can still follow along. So now we've got my data sorted first by country in descending order. Then within each country, I can see that aperture is also in descending order. And then within aperture, I can see that ISO is in ascending order. Okay, hopefully you're catching on by now. Another thing that I just wanted to show you is how we could compare the sort procedure to structured query language. So I have a little bit of code here that's commented out. So what we would do is we would select, and then in the select list, we place the columns that we wanted to select from the table name, whatever the table is that you're capturing information from with structured query language. And here's how we do sorting in PROC SQL. We use the order by clause. And what's kind of interesting is you'll notice that you use the keywords after the variable names instead of in SAS where we use it before the variable names. You'll also notice that the keywords can be shortcutted using DESC to stand for descending and ASC to stand for ascending. One final thing to consider, is it possible that you don't need to sort your data? Sorting, as it turns out, is very resource intensive. I know a great blog that talks about when you might be able to skip sorting and save both time and resources. So look in the links below for a link to that blog, other references, and how to get access to this data so you can try it. Don't forget to subscribe, and please leave me any questions you might have. Thanks for joining me, and I'll see you next time.